Y'all here in First to 10, Clinton, Maryland. Another barber battle with the DMV illest. We in here. We got one of the contestants, Ronell the groomer. Tell everybody where you at, man.
Right now, we're located up at the National Harbor at Colekutz. Returning home to do the battle here at First to 10. It's actually my first battle. I've been called out to a couple of them. Matter of fact, a comb over, I just couldn't find a model for it. But wasn't licensed for a while, so okay. I couldn't
That's what's up. That's what's up. So how you feel about us, you know, DMV illest and what we trying to establish with y'all barbers, man?
I mean, I think it's a good look. I've been saying that we should have had some type of barber union or some type of grouping where all of us from around the DMV area can get together.
Yeah. Okay.
So I feel like it's gonna unify and bring a good look to the
So, how you feel about tonight's event? With the one-on-one, you know the guy that you're going against?
I don't know him, but I follow him on.
Have y'all been DMing each other?
Yeah, we talked a little bit.
Y'all got some trash talking going on a little bit?
Nah, I mean, it was more
on some fun side.
More on the positive side, just happy to have something going on where you can see us people battle when it's not I'm undercutting him or talking smack to him. It's just
good feeling.
And he looked like he's gonna be a good workout. I'm looking at his work, I'm like, they matched us up pretty good. That's what's up.
All right, y'all, we out here, Clinton, Maryland, you know what I'm saying? First and 10, DMV illest. We got one of the contestants right here, Colekutz.
What's going on,
Tell them where you at.
I'm from Frederick, Maryland, man. Came all the way down here. DMV illest invited me, man, so I'm coming to represent. So
cool.
I'm here.
So what you feel about what we trying to do and what we trying to establish with barbers, man?
I think it's excellent that DMV's actually doing this. Or,
okay.
You know, because there's so much talent out here.
It is.
And I just believe that something y'all doing, the illest, there's a lot of barbers out here, licensed and unlicensed, thinking they're the illest. So I think this is the best opportunity for you guys to start this.
That's what's up. How many competitions you been a part of? This can't be your first one.
Nah, this ain't my first. I try to do at least like two or three a year.
Okay, so you've been to the Connecticut one?
That was my first one. It was in Connecticut. I did the tag team competition, the best of both worlds. Mm-hmm. I think I did excellent, you know what I'm saying? Put a nice little lotus in the back of the young lady's head. It came out smooth.
Did you do DC Expo?
Yeah. I did the DC Expo first two times, and I did all right, but I ain't get nothing.
Nah,
so I did one in PA probably about a month and a half, and I did another tag team, and I got third place.
That's what's up. Yeah, congratulations on that.
Appreciate it.
Yeah, so we gonna get into it, you know, real quick.
We got three judges today. All right, we got three judges. Ashley the Barber from Visual Cuts. Visionary Cuts, my bad, Ashley. All right, and then we got Frank Ortiz from Hendrix Barbershop. All right. Then we got Throwback Booby from Throwback Barber and Beauty.
Yeah.
All right, Throwback Booby, baby. Cool. Alright, our first battle was supposed to be a comb over fade, a comb over, but due to forfeit with the barbers, we moved to the next round. So now we got Colekutz, the barber from the one and only barbershop. What's up, baby? Let's get this going. Yes, sir. Let's get this going. Alright, now we got Ronell the groomer from Colekutz at the National Harbor. Yeah. Get this going. All right, so to become the champion of the online barber battle, you must win 5 battles straight. When another barber wins the championship, they'll have to defend their title. All right, so barbers will be cutting a low fade beard tonight. The length and hair on the top must be left at the 1.5 inches, and the sides must be bald to show full transition. You are not allowed to cut, trim, shape, or models have hair before the competition begins. So no type of hair or hairline enhancement. Bring a model with the a grown head cut, like a real grown head cut. All right? Cole, you good?
Oh, yeah.
All right. 5, 4, 3, two, one. Let's get it.
Keep my mind off what I'm doing. Like, I gotta feel like I'm in the shot.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So if I think I'm going against my man right here, it messed me all up.
Oh, I got it.
I'm sitting here asking about what the game going on.
Yeah, I hate. That's what's up.
The music flowing.
Yeah,
good.
Yeah. And you ain't even paying attention to my man over here.
Nah, I can't.
Yeah.
Hey, Jackson, what up? What's up, man?
Yeah. Barnett, how you feel, man?
Another day on the job, man.
That's up. You peeking over there at your boy?
For what?
For what?
That's what I'm talking about.
Peekaboo for what? That's what you're saying. So, with the low fade beard, right? Mm-hmm. What's your preferred method of doing it, man? What clippers to use, or, you know what I'm saying? Tell me about how you go about doing it.
The process for most of them is the same, whether it be low, mid, or high fade. I use what's called a balanced blending technique. I use two guidelines with a modified fast fade or constant toe pass. Blend out bottom line, blend out the top line, keeps everything balanced, and knock your ball off the bottom, and that's it.
Okay.
It's a little different than the technique that they've been doing, but it's like a million and one ways to do it.
Right. My man.
So we kind of came to the conclusion, we're going to talk about both of them. So first, Colekutz, we felt like stuck closer to the guideline of a low fade because you could see the hook. You see what I'm saying? They both had clean cuts though.
Uh-huh.
As far as Ronell, I personally, you know what I'm saying, the transition was a little smoother to me from the skin to the blend, you know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
But from, like, as far as the guidelines is concerned,
right,
as far as the low fade, he stuck the closest, and it was a good overall, like the symmetry, right? Like it was just, you know.
Okay.
So when you stand up, you can see that thing, bing, you know what I'm saying? Slight here and there, I mean, a little right here to blend, a little bit, but that's what I gotta say.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, overall, I'm gonna say that they both had great cuts. If we're going off of based on just the guidelines, I'm gonna go with the Colekutz with the low fade, cutting as low as possible. Like you said, the transitional Ronell's cut was beautiful, and the symmetry, they both were good. The symmetry, the crispiness, and overall, we both good. But if we're going based solely on the guidelines, I'm gonna go with Colekutz for the low fade.
Okay. Yeah, just going through again,
I felt like as far as the fade went, the overall look of the fade, I stuck it with Ronell.
Okay.
How the blend went all the way through. But I felt that overall, Chris's fade was banging, and everything else, as far as the overall cut goes with the sharp shape up in the beard, I just had it give it a cold cut.
Okay. So is that cold cut the winner?
You came up with cold cut.
Okay, yeah. Cold cut's the winner, baby. Clap it up with cold cut. Clap it up with cold cut.
Thank you.
Represent.
Thank you.
Hey,
come on,
Ronnie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I had a ball, man.
Yeah, yeah. That's what's up, man.